If he'd backed up and said, huh, why you can't tell? Y'all,
amen.
I want y'all to think about righteousness by faith. Amen. Faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
Yeah.
So he sent down to Joppa just like the Lord told him to do. The angel told him to do.
Amen.
And he gathered himself down, and Peter come to him, and the first thing he told him, I perceive that God is no respecter of person.
Yeah.
When he started preaching to him.
Amen.
In every nation,
yeah,
he that worketh righteous and fears him is accepted of him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Y'all listen to that?
Amen.
But you got to work righteousness.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
How do you work righteousness? You believe.
That's right.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
You take it. You believe. Abraham believed God and it was counted unto him for righteousness' sake.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
So Cornelius got the Holy Ghost and spoke in another with tongues.
Amen.
Ain't that what it says?
Yeah.
Amen. Didn't say he spoke in other tongues as the Spirit gave him nothing. Didn't say that.
No.
Didn't say that. He spoke in tongues. And they heard him speaking in tongues. Is that right?
Amen.
And Peter said, can any man forbid water that have received the Holy Ghost as well as we? Why not come they didn't speak in other tongue than the Spirit gave us? Mm-hmm. Oh. Oh, they must have learned that in the Pentecost.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
If you don't get it like it was God on the day of Pentecost, you lost. That's folks don't study the word.
Amen.
That's folks ain't studying to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needs not to be ashamed, rightly divide the word of truth.
Amen.
That's people that already got their mind made up. If you don't get it this way, it ain't no way. Well, it's another way, y'all.
Yeah.
Ain't no difference between the Jew or the Gentile.
Amen.
For we all was baptized by the Spirit of God into one body.
That's right.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Whether you was filled with the Holy Ghost on the day of Pentecost or whether you were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise.
Yeah. Right.
You're still saved.
Yeah.
By righteousness.
That's right.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Now, let's go back to the fifth chapter. A Roman. And not only so, we glorify in tribulation. We glory in tribulation. Do we? Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Do we glory in tribulation? God, I thank you for having tribulation. Glory be to God. I'm suffering for your name's sake.
Yeah.
Lord, I ain't got no job and I lost my job and I ain't got no money. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Did we do that?
Lord, thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Y'all listen.
Amen.
Not only so, but we glory in tribulation also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience. Well, the Lord needs to give somebody a little trouble. Some tribulation so they have a little patience. Go, we is very short patience.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sometimes the Lord will hear our cry.
Amen.
When we call it.
Yeah.
He get the answer. And he gonna send it.
Yeah.
But we look for it to come the next 5 minutes.
Amen.
Our next hour.
Yeah.
Our next day.
Yeah.
You know what we need? Be like Job.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
Job had patience.
Amen.
You got your patience got to have faith.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
If you got you sometimes we have faith, but we don't have patience.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
We can say, Lord, I believe you're coming. If he don't come today, we get nervous.
Amen.
If he showed up, don't come in a week, we showed up nervous.
Amen.
We take matters in our own hand.
Yes.
Take action in our own hand.
Yes.
And then we fix the problem.
Yes.
Amen.
Lord, I prayed to you for you to heal my body, but you ain't come yet, so I'm going to see Dr. So-and-so. Uh-huh. Maybe if you'd just had enough patience to wait. Job said, I'm going to wait till my change comes. And he waited on my appointed time. My change will come. So he kept on waiting. He waited 7 long years, and one day God came along. What if he hadn't had no patience? Amen. Didn't faint in his mind, just believe God.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
But the devil moved God against him.
Yeah.
And he without a cause.
Yes.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
But he knew his integrity because he had patience to wait on God.
Amen.
He said, though he slay me, yet will I trust him.
Yes.
But do we glory in tribulation? Y'all listen?
Yes.
Somebody go to the 7th chapter of 1 Corinthians and start at verse 1 and read down to where it says, we joy in tribulation.
Now,
1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, the 2nd chapter.
But I determined this within myself, that I would not come again to you in heaven.
Wait a minute. 1 Corinthians, the 7th chapter, 2 Corinthians, the 7th chapter, and verse 1. Starts off. Let us cling, having these promises.
Having therefore these promises.
Now, what he talking about is the 6th chapter.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
He said, be ye separated. Didn't.
Amen.
Come out from among them and test not the unclean thing, and I will receive you.
Yeah.
And I'll, other words, I'll walk in you, and you'll be my sons and my daughters, and I'll be your God.
Yes.
He said, having these, therefore these promises, let us cleanse what? Dearly beloved, ourselves from all what? Filters of the flesh. And we say, Lord, take the taste of this alcohol for me. He didn't give it to you.
Amen. Yeah.
Who picked that alcohol habit there? The Lord don't drink. Y'all listen. He ain't never drank, smoked, chewed tobacco. He ain't never done none of that.
Yeah.
Well, don't you know if you picked up that habit, you can tell your own self, I don't have to have that and I ain't doing it.
Amen.
Amen.
But we wait for God to do everything.
Yeah.
Y'all listen.
Amen.
Some of us that do wrong to our fellow brother or sister, we do it wrong, then we go fall down on knees and go to crying. Lord, forgive me. I done wrong. Well, you had the wrong fellow. You went to the wrong one first. You should go back to that when you transgress against or offend
me.
And get reconciled up. Then come back to God and offer up your prayer for thanksgiving.
Amen.
For getting forgiveness. Y'all listen?
Amen.
I die and go to hell for I ask you to forgive me. I ain't, that's where you going.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Exactly where you going. Because if you don't forgive people that they trespass, neither will your heavenly Father forgive you of your trespass.
That's right. Amen.
Yeah.
And we know, I don't believe every time you see that person, you look up and think about what he done to you.
No.
The Lord said in the covenant, new covenant, that he'll blot out of our sin. And he'll remember no more.
Yeah.
Well, now, if I'm the Spirit of God is in me and I got the Spirit of God in me, if he can blot him out and forgive and remember no more, we ought to forgive, be able to do that. Y'all?
Amen.
Yes, I'm going to forgive you, but I sure ain't going to forget it. And every time you look up and see him coming, you think about what he done to you. You ain't forgave him.
That's right.
Amen.
Y'all?
Yeah.
Y'all, what if the Lord would be like that?
Amen.
He blots out our transgression. He blots out our sin.
Amen.
Y'all understand?
Yeah.
Come on, read.
Having therefore these promises, dear beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit. Perfecting holiness in the fear of God.
Perfecting holiness in the fear of God.
Receive us. We have wronged no man.
Y'all listen to that?
Amen.
He said, receive us, we have wronged no man. How did we get to be, before we read in the morning, how did we get to be the begotten children of God? What begot us? Paul said in the 4th chapter of 1 Corinthians, though he have 10,000 instructors. Y'all listen.
Amen.
I have begotten you through the gospel.
Yeah.
God loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
Yeah.
Well, that same son, we have to be begotten through his gospel.
Amen.
I don't care how many instructors you got, how many teachers, the gospel is what begot you to become a son of God.
Yeah.
Y'all listen.
Amen.
If we believe the gospel.
Amen.
Come on, read something, man.
We have corrupt no man.
We have corrupt no man.
We have defrauded no man.
We have defrauded no man.
I speak not this to condemn you.
I speak not this to condemn you.
For I have said before.
For I have said before.
That ye are in our hearts to die and to live with you. Great is my boldness of speech toward you.
Come on. Yes.
I am filled with comfort.
This is what he said. I am filled with comfort. Come on.
I am exceedingly joyful.
I am exceedingly joyful.
In all our tribulations.
Oh, Lord. God help us.
Yes.
The joy of the Lord is your strength, we say.
Amen.
Well, well. Well, if your strength and tribulation come, you ought to be rejoicing.
Amen. Yeah.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
Sometimes we just read something and we go off it. But when all that tribulation rise up, Paul still had the joy of the Lord. When they were thorning him and beating him with a cat of nine tails. And the other thing that he was hungry, he had took it with joy.
Yeah.
Read that again, Sister May.
Great is my boldness of speech toward you.
Come on. Great is my glory of you.
I am filled with comfort.
Y'all listen to that?
Yeah.
Are we filled with comfort tonight?
Oh, God.
People say supposed to. I didn't ask that. I asked what we're for.
Amen.
The comfort is the Holy Ghost. Is that right?
Yeah.
It's the Spirit of truth.
Yeah.
Come on. I am exceedingly joyful in all our tribulation. If you want patience, you know what you ask the Lord for? Trouble.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm going back to the 5th chapter of Romans. Come on. 4th verse. And patience. 5th chapter of Romans. I'm going back there. I ain't never got away from it. And not only so, but we glory in tribulation also. Knowing that tribulation worketh patience. And patience, experience. And experience, hope. Y'all understand?
Amen.
We always wishing, I hope I can do so and so.
Yeah.
Boy, I hope I can be able to get me a new car.
Amen.
I hope I'll be able to get me a new home. I hope.
Yeah.
Well, you looking at that?
Amen.
Hope that is seen is not hope.
Amen.
Hope is just like faith.
Yeah.
It's something you don't see.
That's
right. He said, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
Amen.
Why should you hope for it when you're looking at it?
That's right.
But I hope for that I don't see.
Amen.
Then I with patience wait for it.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Say, ain't no different than faith No, it's a difference in faith and hope. You tell me what difference it is. I can tell you, Paul said in the 13th chapter of 1 Corinthians about faith.
Yes. Amen.
He said, there are three. Faith, hope, and charity. But the greatest of these is charity.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yes.
You have faith that you can remove a mountain.
Yes.
That's going to make the love of God be in you.
Right. Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
And all folk want to do is get to where they can lay hands on somebody and heal them and go off and brag about it. I laid my hands on them and God healed them. No. And I healed them. Y'all listen?
Amen.
I laid my hand on that brother and the power of God come on him and he fell out. And everybody wants to heal and work miracles. But nobody wants to obey the Lord and get what it takes to do that.
That's right.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
Boy, I'm praying for to get the gift of laying on the hand. Well, I'm praying for the love of God.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
Because if I get the love of God in me, then them gifts will automatically come.
That's right.
Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We seek the gift and not love.
That's right.
Yeah.
A gift without love don't mean nothing.
That's right.
Amen.
So everybody wants to do that. And folk, you can came with us. It's going to be a healing meeting here tonight. They're going to raise the dead and the blind eyes are going to be open. And you let one person in the room get healed and everybody will come down. You know what they're coming after? Healing.
Yeah.
But how many are going to get saved by grace through faith?
Yes.
Let's think about 10 lepers. I want you to think about it. It was 10 of them.
Amen.
And the Lord healed them. Is that right?
Yes.
Yeah. Nine of them went on about their business.
Amen.
Because all they wanted was the lepers clean.
Yeah.
If people want to keep on doing what they're doing and get healed, and the Lord tell them, go sin no more.
Yeah.
At least the worst thing will come upon you.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
And so everybody wants to be healed.
Amen.
But they don't want the healer.
That's right.
And the healer is Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Them folks had them loaves and fish, they came back sick of Jesus because they had the loaves in the field.
That's right. Amen.
They weren't sick of Jesus for his salvation or what he had for them.
Amen.
Wasn't it?
No.
But now everybody wants to do that. And the whole world is trying to go right after.
Yeah.
You just do what the Lord said do.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
I can't heal nobody.
No.
Y'all listen? You can't heal?
No.
Peter, when he said, silver and gold have I none, such as I have, give I thee.
Amen.
He didn't claim that he healed that man.
No.
They come down looking, wondering. Look at him. He said, what you looking at us for? And it is by our holiness, or by our power, we have made this man whole.
Amen.
He let him know who done it, didn't he?
Right.
He wasn't seeking his own glory. He was seeking the glory of God.
That's right.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
And he let the people know that.
That's right.
Yeah.
But we want to stick our chest out big.
Amen.
I prayed for that brother.
Yeah.
And that sister. And brother, they got it. I moved the Lord.
Yeah.
He heard my cry.
Yeah.
Y'all listen? We brag and boast.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
You might get that done, but you don't get that done.
Amen.
Because you didn't give God the glory.
Yeah.
Y'all listen? You ain't got no power to forgive no sins.
That's right.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
You ain't got no power to heal nobody except God give it to you.
That's right.
Amen.
And you act like it's God done it through you. I'm just a hand.
That's right.
Amen.
So it's Bonnie, you sold, don't you?
Yes.
And you make clothes. You got a pair of scissors.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Them scissors don't cut now piece of nothing by themselves, dude.
That's right.
Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
Yeah.
Brother Larry, you work. That tractor ain't gonna crank up. Dick now back dick nothing. You got the operation.
Right. Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm talking about I'm trying to get you to see something. God will work through us if we stay meek and lowly and humble and give him the glory. Because it ain't us, it's him.
Amen.
Paul said, it's not I, but the Christ that liveth in me.
Amen.
So it ain't about you. It's about Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
And when we learn that and quit being big-minded and high-minded and headed, then the Lord might do something for us.
Yeah. Yeah.
But he said, let your light so shine before men and women, amen, that they'll see your good works and glorify you.
Yeah.
Oh. But the people like to get patting on the back.
Yeah.
I don't want you patting on the back. I don't want you to recognize me. Because the Lord going to do that for me.
Yeah.
You just take what I said and live by it and don't be obedient to it.
Right.
And the Lord will do something for you.
Right.
And I'm going to tell you, Armand, and I ain't going to be high-minded, and I hope you'll be the same. God, I can get an answer from God.
Amen.
I prayed to God and God took my headache. And I know the Lord will hear my prayer.
Uh-huh.
I know he hears me. Y'all listen?
Amen.
That's why I'm going to say this. Some people think God is over yonder God.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
I thought God was everywhere.
Yes. Right.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
When I was in Dallas, Texas, that's what these people do. The Lord moved. When he gets to Leesville, he don't do nothing. When he gets to the river, he don't do nothing.
Uh-huh.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If God was in you in Leesville, he ought to be in you when you get to the river.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
But he's a over yonder God.
Uh-huh.
The Lord opened blind eyes over in Dallas.
Uh-huh.
Or in New Orleans. But he gets here, he folks just out there by the drove. He won't do nothing for nobody. So I call him over yonder God, Brother John. He works over yonder. But he don't work over him. He's the same God, Jesus, in Israel. He's the same God in the river.
Right.
He's done for me what he done for the Israelites.
Yeah.
He's done for me what he done for Cornelius.
Right.
He's done for me what I could do for myself.
Yeah.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So God's ears is open.
Amen.
Ain't it?
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
His prayers, the righteous pray and cry. He heard, he listened there.
Yeah.
What about the wicked? I want you to think about Simon and Sasha. Simon was a bewusher.
Yeah.
He wanted to be some great somebody.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
And he saw that when Peter and John laid hands on them folk, got the Holy Ghost, he wanted to buy.
Yeah.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Oh, whosoever I laid my hands on, they can get the Holy Ghost. Boy, he had him a money scheme right. Peter said to him, well, God bless you, brother. God gonna bless you and you gonna get it. Is that what he told him?
No.
What he told him? What did he say to him?
He told him his money perished with him.
Why?
Because he thought that the gift of God made his purchase with money.
Y'all listen to that?
Amen.
Come on, read the rest of it.
Thou hast neither part nor lot in this matter.
Oh, wonder why. He had M-O-E-Y on his mind.
Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Preachers can't get nothing now. They get a sermon. The next thing at the end of the TV program, they got it up there for how much? So much.
Amen.
Well, the disciples didn't do that. He told the disciples that freely ye have received, freely give.
Yeah.
Amen.
But we sell everything now.
Yeah.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Everybody don't do that, y'all listen. Because I don't.
Yeah.
Amen.
I don't sell nothing.
No.
I don't take no money for preaching. I took that up on myself. I can, a workman is labor worth of his heart.
Yes.
But I'd rather not, I'd rather preach the gospel without charge. So people say, that man ain't out there for nothing but money.
Amen.
The Lord gonna take care of me.
Yeah.
Because I'm gonna do what the Lord say to do.
Yeah.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
And I have power to take if I want to.
Amen.
But I choose not, because everybody's out after to get the dollars.
Yeah.
And I don't say you don't need money to operate the church. I'm not saying that.
Yes.
But that gets to be the main issue.
Yes.
Amen.
When soul winning ought to be the main issue.
That's right.
Yeah.
Come on. Who was reading?
I was in Acts. He said, "For thy heart is not right in the sight of God."
Well, now you tell me if your heart, if you feel what the Holy Ghost says, your heart gonna be right?
Yeah.
Well, what Peter tell him, your heart is not right in the sight of God. Must have been the Holy Ghost there.
That's
did
right.
He wasn't been trying to buy?
That's right.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Come on, read.
Repent therefore of this thy wickedness and pray God.
Come on.
For I perceive that thou art in the gall of bitterness.
Uh-huh.
And in the bond of iniquity.
Oh. Didn't bless him, did he?
Amen.
Come on.
Then answered Simon and said,
what?
Pray ye to the Lord for me, that none of these things which ye have spoken come upon me.
That's good. Go back to the 5th chapter of Romans and I'm going to pick up verse 5. And hope maketh not ashamed. Y'all listen to that? Hope don't make ashamed. Why? Because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. For when we were yet without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. What if everybody had been godly? Then Jesus Christ would have never had to come and die.
That's right.
But everybody was on the scene, mm-hmm. both Jews and Gentiles.
Yes.
For scarcely for a righteous man will one die. Yet pre-adventure for a good man will some even die to die. But God commended his love towards us. Y'all listen to that?
Mm-hmm.
In that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Y'all
listen.
Much more, verse 9. Then, being now justified by his blood. Y'all listen to that?
Amen.
We shall be saved from wrath through him. Y'all listen.
Amen.
Not by what you've done, it's through him.
That's right.
For if when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his son. Being much more being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life.
Yes.
Y'all listen to that?
Amen.
It's all about him.
That's right. Amen.
Y'all listen to that?
Amen.
We shall be saved by his life. And not only so, but we joy in God. Y'all listen to that?
Amen.
Through our Lord Jesus Christ. Y'all listen to that?
Amen.
Y'all already listening?
Amen.
But we joy in God through what?
Our Lord Jesus.
Over in the 13th chapter of Hebrews, it said, by him. Y'all listen?
Amen.
Let us offer the sacrifice of praise.
Yes.
By him. Continually.
Mm-hmm.
That is the fruit of our lips.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't that what it says?
Right.
Or in Ephesians or Colossians, he said, be not filled with wine. Be not drunk with wine, which is excess. But be filled with the Spirit. Singing with grace in your heart unto the Lord.
That's right.
Who is grace?
Jesus.
So it's by him.
Yes.
Folks like to sing because they can sing real good.
Yes.
Preach good, real good. They don't want to sell everything and sell. Mm-hmm. Sing. They've cut them little, these little groups right and got to where they trying to cut records and sell them.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
Well, Jesus Christ didn't sell the gospel.
Amen.
Peter didn't sell the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
Paul didn't sell the gospel. He preached the gospel without choice. And every time we get something pretty good, and they won't tell you, say, they'll say, send me $25 or more, and we'll send it to you. Well, you send it. I got to have me some nothing for my operating expenses. Paul didn't take nothing for his operating expenses. He said, buy the truth and do what? Oh. Said, you can't do nothing for the truth, against the truth. Because the truth going to stand.
Yes.
The truth going to stand whether you believe it or not.
That's right.
And we don't have to sell everything God give it to us.
Right.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Right.
Why? He didn't send it to me. Why should I tell Brother John back there, I said, when you leave out here, leave me a donation of $25.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
You know, he taping me. He take me every sermon I preach. I don't want no money. Mm-hmm. And I hope he play them for somebody else can hear them.
Right.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
And I hope he don't charge for them. And I believe Brother John ain't going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Amen.
Y'all ever listen to the preacher on TV now? You turn the TV on, y'all got to get all the preacher stations. Did you ever hear anybody offer anything on free of charge? It sent me a as much as $5.
Uh-huh.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
But I don't want you to, I ain't going to ask you for one cent.
Amen.
For what I'm preaching.
No.
I'm not going to do that. I want you to hear it, the gospel, and believe it and obey it.
That's right.
And I'll get more out of that than if you give me $100,000.
Right.
Y'all know what I'm saying?
Because
money will not save you. You can't serve God and mammon too.
Right.
Y'all
listen?
Yeah. Either you're going to love the money and hate God.
Right.
Or either you're going to love God and hate the money.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
He said, I'm going to show y'all something before I'm going to close in just a minute. Did the Lord tell us to be content with such things as we have?
Yes.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Did you ever find yourself you ain't being that way?
Yes.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
What we got to mumble about? Grumble.
Nothing.
Don't sure don't look like no hungry folks in here to me. Ain't nobody in here suffering from malnutrition.
No.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There's people in the world that suffer from malnutrition.
Amen.
And we grumbling about, I don't want them old leftovers.
Yeah.
Y'all listen. March to the door and throw them out.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
My wife don't cook very often.
Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I eat leftovers.
Amen.
And if you come to my house and say you don't eat leftovers, you eating leftovers.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah. y'all listen.
Amen.
Seem like it tastes a whole lot better to me when it's leftover.
Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What is I got? I got a whole house to stay in.
Amen.
I don't need no clothes.
No.
Ain't bought none for years.
Amen.
No matter how many people think I do it, I don't buy them.
Yeah.
I got off into that and got hooked on it.
Yeah.
And I was just like a dope addict.
Yeah.
People that's hooked on gambling.
Amen.
I'd go borrow the money to buy and pay notes back at the bank.
Yeah.
Y'all know what I'm saying?
Amen.
And then I had a bit more need for them than that drone did. When I come to myself, I cried and prayed and asked the Lord to forgive me. That's lust. That's not being content with such things as you have.
Amen.
And you go to the closet, and you look at it.
Yeah.
You pull it back.
Amen.
I believe I'll wear this. No.
Amen.
I don't like the way that look. Y'all see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I believe I'll try this suit put out. No, I ain't what it is. I don't want that. But if you have a one up there, that's you go and get that one or two. You pick and pull up one of them down.
Amen.
But John preached, if you have two coats, what did he say? Show you how we are. Now what right we have to grumble and mumble? The Lord is providing us with food, raiment, and shelter.
Amen.
And with a job and with some money.
Yes.
I get my Social Security check every month.
Amen.
Rain or shine.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
Y'all listen what I'm saying?
Amen.
I got a house. And it belongs to me and my wife and the Lord.
Amen.
Y'all listen?
Yeah.
He blessed us to have one.
Amen.
I don't need a house.
No.
I don't need a building made with hands.
No.
I'm looking for a city.
Amen.
Who's building and maker of God.
Amen.
For here we have no continuing city. I'm not looking for bright lights.
No.
I'm being content with what the Lord blessed me. I'm just as happy. I'm going back there tonight. If I live in the Lord's will, nothing happens. And I'm going to get me a little food, and I'm going to thank him for it, and I'm going to sit down and eat it. And I might eat cold.
Amen. Yeah.
I can get right out of the refrigerator and eat anything.
Yeah. Yeah.
I train myself to be content. What if one day I go there and the lights is out of gas, though?
Amen. Yeah.
I can get sweet stuff and pecans or peanuts right out of the freezing and go to eating.
Amen.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Y'all believe that?
Yeah.
Fish can get in, stay in the box for 2 days.
Yeah.
Boy, that's when it's good. I get it right out of there. Whole cold chicken. Y'all, my wife said, how do you eat that?
Amen.
I said, you know what? I'm training myself.
Yeah.
One day I might have to eat that.
Amen.
And I won't be sitting down. I can't eat this cold. If you're hungry, you're going to lap it in.
Amen.
Yes. Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yes.
If you're hungry, you'll eat. But if you choice it, what is that? That don't look good. Look can be deceiving.
Amen.
Yes.
Yeah.
Y'all listen to what I'm saying?
Yeah.
My wife made New Orleans pecan pie. Y'all listen?
Yeah.
And she said, shh. And Don and Cheryl, they lied. But Justin Beverly, his wife, they looked at him. I don't want that. Ooh, that looked nasty. You know, you make them all that stuff on. Like, y'all know what New Orleans coupon pie look like? He make them and all that cream building after get a little cold, all that breaks up. And they don't look good at all. But I dare you to try it out. So they kept on. And no, I don't want this. Well, why don't you just taste it? They was in Lake Charles. And they fooled around there and taste that thing. That New Orleans pecan pie. And that hell was they was up there from New Orleans pecan pie. But they wouldn't eat it because it didn't look good. Sometimes you go around, you got old house, got termites in it.
Yeah.
Boy, it look good. But you better not back off and kick it.
Yeah.
Your whole feet are going through that.
Yeah.
But it look good.
Yeah.
Y'all listen?
Amen.
But the termites don't need to do.
Yeah. Yeah.
So don't go by looks.
That's right.
Always try it out. Beloved, believe not in the spirit, but try them and see what they of God. Because men is false prophets going into the world. Lord, we thank you tonight. For the word. We thank you, Lord, for blessing us to be here tonight.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, I hope somebody got something out of what I brought tonight.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, help our people in throughout the world.
Yes.
There's hungry people, Lord,
yes,
over in
Lord.
War and in trouble,
yes,
and don't have nowhere to stay right here in the United States of America.
Yes. Yes.
Lord, help the people, all of us, to feed the poor,
yes,
the hungry,
yes,
Lord, you told us the poor would always be among us.
Yes. Yes.
And Lord, people don't say ain't no poor people. It always will be poor people.
Yes, Lord.
Because you said they're always to be among us.
Yes.
So Lord, help us.
Yes,
Jesus. To share what we have.
Yes, Lord.
Help us, Lord, to love.
Yes, Lord.
Let it help our faith to work by love.
Yes, Jesus.
And if our faith work by love, Lord, then we'll share with our brothers and needed brothers and sisters.
Yes.
Lord, we got people right here.
Yes, Jesus.
Comes around and we look at them and don't help them.
Yes, Lord.
But Lord, one day you can take away my Social Security check.
Yes, Lord.
You can burn my house down or blow it down.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, I won't have nothing.
Yes, Jesus.
So Lord, help me.
Yes,
not
Lord.
To be high-minded.
Yes, Lord.
But to communicate and to share.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, we thank you for it.
Thank
Amen.
Lord. Amen.
We thank the Lord tonight.
Yes. Yes.
Any of y'all got anything to say before we dismiss? I kept y'all a little longer tonight. It was pretty late when I got up here. Watch, fast, and pray. You're dismissed in the name of Lord Jesus Christ.